Well, this morning, we're going to spend time praying as we normally do, but I just want to exhort us a little bit and then we will pray. If you've been following our prayer and our devotion this week, we've been focusing on building our capacity. Whatever God calls us to do, He gives us the ability to do it. Whatever God calls us to do, He gives us the ability to do it. If God calls you to be the head and not the tail, He gives you the ability to be the head and not the tail. When God calls you to be a conqueror, He gives you the ability to be a conqueror. Whatever God calls you to do, He gives you the ability to do it. Now, many times when God calls us to do things, we look at ourselves, we look at our own abilities, we look at our weaknesses, and all of us are aware of our weaknesses. We know things we can't do. We know things we have failed at. But when God calls you to do something that you failed at before, He gives you the ability to do it. The moment He calls you, He gives you ability. And the Holy Spirit is the one who comes upon us to give us the ability to do the things that God wants us to do. So I don't know what God has called you to do spiritually, maybe in business, maybe in academia, wherever He's called you to do. Even if He calls you to be a husband, He gives you the ability to be a husband. If He calls you to be a wife, He gives you the ability to be a wife. All of us, there will always be something you don't know how to do, but which you have to do. I didn't know how to be a husband until I became a husband. I didn't know how to be a father until I became a father. I didn't know how to pastor until I became a pastor. And so there will always be the first time you do something, or there's always going to be something you want to do that you don't know how to do. And when you don't know what to do, the Holy Spirit gives you the ability to do it. So we're going to look at a few scriptures of the Holy Spirit giving people the ability to do things. And then I'll wind it up a little with what Jesus says to us. And then we will pray. Is that okay for everybody? All right. So we're going to stay mostly in the book of Judges. Then we'll transition to the New Testament. Throughout the Bible, you would realize that whenever God gives people a task, whether it's Moses, it's Noah, it's Abraham, whenever God tells somebody to do something, He gives them the ability to do it. And we're just going to look at incidents in the book of Judges. The first is in Judges chapter 3, verse 9 and 10. It is about Othniel, who is a judge of Israel. Judges 3, 9 and 10. When the children of Israel cried out to the Lord raised up a deliverer for the children of Israel who delivered them, Othniel, the son of Kenaz, Caleb's younger brother. Verse 10, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him and he judged Israel. I want you to note the phrase, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. Then we go to Judges chapter 6 and verse 33 to 34. This is about Gideon. Then all the Midianites and Amalekites, the people of the east, gathered together and they crossed over and encamped in the valley of Jezreel. At that time, Israel is being dominated by the Midianites, and the Midianites are gathered for war. Verse 34, but the Spirit of the Lord came upon Gideon and he blew the trumpet and the Abiezrites gathered behind him. I want you to note the phrase, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. The same thing that happened to Othniel happened to Gideon. Then Judges chapter 11, verse 29, Jephthah. Then the Spirit of the Lord came upon Jephthah, and he passed through Gilead, and Manasseh passed through Mizpah of Gilead, and so on and so forth. Then Judges chapter 13, verse 24 and 25. This is about Samson. So the woman bore a son and called his name Samson, and the child grew, and the Lord blessed him, and the Spirit of the Lord began to move upon him. The common thread you see in all these stories is these were ordinary people. Jephthah was a wayward boy. Othniel, we don't know much about him. Gideon was a farmer. All of these people, Samson was just a boy born to a couple who were expecting a child and had suffered to have a child. But each one of them, God called them to be a deliverer. And each one of them in their own ability could not be a deliverer. But what made them deliverers was because the Spirit of the Lord came upon them. And when the Spirit of God comes upon you, what you couldn't do before, you will do. Because the Spirit of God is our enabler. He takes ordinary people and does extraordinary things with them. And in this whole season, as we wait on the Lord and as we pray, one of the things we have to believe God for is that the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. And when the Spirit of God comes upon you, then whatever God wants you to do, He enables you to do it. If you couldn't carry a tune to sing, when the Spirit of God comes upon you, you will sing to the highest note. If you couldn't read, the Spirit of God comes upon you, you will read. You couldn't reason properly, the Spirit of God comes upon you, you will reason properly. Whatever you couldn't do, the answer is the Spirit of God coming upon you. And may that same Spirit that fell upon Othniel and fell upon Gideon and fell upon Jephthah and fell upon Samson, may that Spirit rest upon you this morning. Somebody say, I receive it. Then we go to the New Testament and we see the same pattern repeated. We start with Mary, the mother of Jesus, Luke chapter 1, verse 35. And the angel answered and said, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you. Therefore also that Holy One who is to be born shall be called the Son of God. The same phrase, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The Holy Spirit will overshadow you. I like that term, overshadow. Overshadow means you cover something so much so that you don't see the thing again except the thing that has covered it. So it's like somebody puts a blanket on you and covers you totally so that when anybody sees you, they see a blanket. They don't see you again because you have been overshadowed. The blanket now is representing you. So when the Holy Spirit overshadows you, it means the Holy Spirit takes so much control over your life that what you manifest is no longer you, but the Holy Spirit. And this morning, we want the Holy Spirit to so overshadow us that whatever we manifest will not be us, but the Holy Spirit. We want to go to work tomorrow morning so overshadowed by the Holy Spirit that whatever comes out is not us, but the Holy Spirit. Mary was wondering, how could it be possible for this miracle you're talking about to happen to me? And it say, the angel says, the Holy Spirit will overshadow you. May the Holy Spirit overshadow each one of us. So we see, not only in the Old Testament, but we see this story in the New Testament. And we see it in the life of our Lord Jesus Christ himself. Matthew chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. And when he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water. And behold, the heavens were opened to him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting upon him. And suddenly a voice from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, in whom I'm well pleased. Jesus is the Son of God. But for 30 years, nobody knew about him. A few people had spiritual perception of him. They had prophesied at his birth. But he was just the village carpenter. That's all he was, the village carpenter. Until John shows up and everybody says, you must be the Messiah. John says, no. There's one coming after me. And the one who sent me says, I would know when I see him. Now you have to understand that John is slightly older than Jesus, about 6 months older than Jesus, and is a cousin of Jesus. He knew cousin Jesus or cousin Yeshua. He knew him. But he didn't know Cousin Yeshua, the carpenter, was anything more than Cousin Yeshua. So he goes out to preach, and God says, I'm going to show you the Messiah. How am I going to know? He said, you will know. How can I tell? You will know. So then he sees Cousin Yeshua coming to be baptized and puts him in the water. He comes out, and the heavens open, and the Spirit of God comes upon his cousin, and he realized, wow, I've been living with the Son of God for 30 years. He probably repaired my chair for me, and I didn't know. But the Holy Spirit came upon Jesus, and Cousin Yeshua went about doing outstanding miracles and signs and wonders. But it all began when the Holy Spirit endorsed him at his baptism. I believe this morning something will come upon you. People who have just known you as sister so-and-so and brother so-and-so, and they just know you as a friend, as just some ordinary person they've known for 30 years, for 40 years, for 20 years, for 25 years. But today something will hit you, and when it hits you, everybody would know, this is the man of God, this is the woman of God, this is the person God has called. May the heavens be open over our lives. May the heavens be open over our lives. Oh yes, it's going to open. But this didn't end with Jesus himself. Jesus said, what happened to my mother happened to me, will happen to you also. Acts chapter 1 verse 8. But you shall receive power. Somebody say, I receive power. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. But you shall receive power. This word power is not just passive power. It is power that gets the work done. Power that gets the work done. Maybe you look at a task in front of you and you say, it's too big, it's too high, it's too much, but you shall receive power. You shall receive power. Just like Jephthah received power, and Othniel received power, and Gideon received power, and Samson received power, and Mary received power, and Jesus received power. He says, don't just read about it, experience it. Because what happened to them is about to happen to you. This morning, we want that same Holy Spirit to overshadow us. Some of us are filled with the Holy Spirit, but he hasn't overshadowed us. We see ourselves always as the one who must do the work. But God says today, I want you to see, this is not your work. It's not by might. It's not by power. It's by my Spirit. If God says you will be a millionaire, it's not by might, it's not by power, it's by his Spirit. And the same Spirit that wins wars also makes millionaires. The same Spirit that caused a woman without a man to give birth to a child is the same Spirit that will cause you to do what God has called you to do. And the same Spirit that took the village carpenter and did mighty works with him, that same Spirit rests upon us. And this morning, we want to come conscious of the Holy Spirit's power, that he will overshadow us. Whatever weakness you have, the Holy Spirit will overshadow it. Whatever limitation you have, the Holy Spirit will overshadow it. Whatever failure you have had in the past, the Holy Spirit will overshadow it. Your failure will not destroy you. Your failure will not limit you. Your failure will not push you back. Because when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, your failure will disappear. He's like a blanket that is thrown upon you, like a blanket that is thrown upon you, like a blanket that is thrown upon you. Oh Lord, blanket your people this morning. Blanket your people with the Holy Spirit. Let there be a blanketing of the Holy Spirit. If you want to receive, why don't you put yourself in a position to receive? Everybody rise up on your feet and lift up your hands to heaven, because something is coming from heaven. It is lighting upon you. The heavens are being opened this morning. The heavens are being opened this morning. The heavens are being opened this morning. Heavens are being opened. The Spirit of God is coming upon you in power, in signs, in wonders. Whatever God calls you to do, He gives you the ability to do it. I don't know what you believe God has called you to do. Whatever He has called you to do, whatever God spoke to you about, whatever God says He is going to use you for, He gives you the ability to do it. And this morning, ability is being rolled out. Like blanket, ability is falling upon God's people. Like blanket, ability is falling upon God's people. Let's just be in the presence of the Lord as the Holy Spirit envelopes us, as the Holy Spirit overshadows us, as the Holy Spirit comes upon the people of God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the heavens are open. The heavens are open. The heavens are open. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Overshadow your people this morning. Overshadow your people this morning. Can I have the praise team quickly? Overshadow your people this morning. Overshadow your people this morning. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, thou art your miracles and signs, yes, and wonders.
Yes.
Every miracle is not a healing. Every miracle is not deliverance. Every miracle is not the Red Sea opening. Sometimes the miracle is somebody who cannot stand in public standing in public. Sometimes the miracle is somebody who is timid becoming bold. Sometimes the miracle is somebody who has failed doing things 1,000 times, all of a sudden succeeding. Sometimes the miracle is somebody who is 67 years and has not achieved much in life. All of a sudden, the heavens open and everything begins to change around that person. So I don't know what unusual miracle you are believing God for. I don't know what unusual work you want God to do in your life. But this morning you want the Holy Spirit to overshadow you, because the unusual will become usual.
The abnormal will become normal. The undone will be done in your life. Your failure will be overshadowed. Lift up your hands to heaven and receive from him. Let's sing, Holy Spirit, come upon me.
Holy Spirit, thou art welcoming.
Yes.
Holy Spirit.
Chapter 10. The prophet Samuel prophesied to a young man who had lost his way looking for his father's donkeys. And Samuel prophesied to that young man, his name is Saul. And he says, when you leave my presence, something is going to happen. You're going to meet a company of prophets. And they will prophesy, and then he used that phrase, and the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. And Samuel said, when that thing happens, you will be turned into another man. This morning, people are going to be turned into another woman, into another man, into another person. Who you were before you came to church will change. You will become another person. You will become another person. You lift up your hands and say, Lord, make me what you want me to be. Kaya Zutaya, Ikatore, Eseporikia, Nimokoseya Lamaka. Weaknesses are being swallowed up. Limitations are being swallowed up. Fearful people are being made strong. People with no vision are receiving vision. People who were tired are receiving new strength. People who were disappointed are being given a new appointment. In the name of Jesus, receive from the Lord this morning. Another man, another woman, another man, another woman, another man, another woman. Your strength is being renewed. Let your prayer ascend to the Lord. Change me, Lord. Touch me, Lord. Give me what I didn't have before. Make me who I was not before. Turn me into another person. The person after your heart. The person after your heart. The person after your heart. The person of power. A mighty warrior, a mighty warrior, a mighty warrior, a mighty warrior. Come on,
broken.
Into another life.
Mental limitations are being broken. Confidence is being restored. Kaya sotakana. Kori isatakaya.
Into service as a burden is lifted. You came here discouraged and afraid, but you're living here bold and confident. You came here with shame, but you are living here with honor and glory. You came here confused, but you're living here with clarity of mind and vision. Whatever was a burden, whatever was a limitation, whatever kept you back, the Holy Spirit has consumed it. There is an overshadowing over your life. For the last time, lift up your hands to God and just say, Lord, overshadow me by your Holy Spirit completely. Completely, 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 fully change me, change me, change me, change me into another person, the person you want me to be, the person you want me to be. Change me, Lord, change me, Lord, change me, Lord. By your Spirit, by your Spirit, consume me, consume me, consume me fully, totally, absolutely. In the name of Jesus, this morning, as Samuel said to Saul, And when that happens and the Spirit of God comes upon you, you'll be turned into another man, into another woman. And he says, from then on, whatever your hand finds to do, do it. Because God is with you. The battles you fight after today, you will win them. The battles you fight after today, you will win them. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. The power of the Most High overshadows you from today. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Somebody celebrate the Lord. Celebrate His goodness. Celebrate His mercy. Glory be to God. I don't know about you, but I sense that this month has been a very unusual month. Don't ever dissipate a move of the Holy Spirit. That means you can't be in the presence of God and leave as if nothing happened. When you leave the presence of God, you must be conscious of the presence of God. You must be conscious of what you have received, and you must activate it in your life. So from this moment, don't ever lose what you have received. Because whatever you felt today, it is not a feeling just for this moment. It is a new empowerment. It's a new direction. It's a new leading. It's a new drive that has come into your life. And God is going to strengthen your hand and your arm. He will strengthen your face. He will strengthen your voice. He will strengthen your step. And whatever He tells you to do, do it. Because the Lord is with you. And great and mighty things will be done by you. In Jesus' name. Amen.